Hello, this is Miss Squirrel. I'm a dog puppy. He's sleeping next to me, snoring and farting. I don't know if you can hear. But today I'm talking about getting money without trying to sell. And I don't ask you to stand in a bank, yell and sell item. Selling item, selling item, selling fucking item. No. What I mean is to have items in your bank that people actually need and ask, so you can just trade without hassle. And I got this idea to talk about this because earlier today I was in World 1. I was trying to buy food for Paro Strip. And yes, I will make that next video about Paro Strip, and I saw my loots. But I was buying food, and I noticed that it was easier to sell items than buy food. After a bit, I already had like few hundred K without selling, just trading people who was asking to buy. And it surprised me. So I was thinking that, okay, I will remind people of this. And those items are often very cheap. They are basic items. They are needed for quests and clues like a middle axe, iron pickaxe, hand boots, you know, those Uri's emote items. And I know that our banks are very small, and you might think that, oh hell with that, I don't have space. But if your bank is full, just stay on items that you need yourself. Like if you do clues, stay on clue items. If you use a lot of game necklace and dual ring, stack on those so you can sell those. If you do smithing, have bars like gold, silver and iron, so you can sell those if people are asking. It doesn't need much from you, but you can make actually money off those. And I can't give you right list because those items actually are different in every bank. In Warrock, people is asking different items than in Raynor Bank, and in Edgeville they are asking again different items. Well, usually. And but if you skill, for example, fletch or make potions, every day after day in same bank, read the public chat and learn to know what people are willing to buy. You will notice soon that those same items are all the time on the chat, so you can actually take advantage of that. In World 1 and 2, people do buy those items, well, all kind of items, and you can get rid of faster of those items. But when you are in normal world, like non-trade world, people do buy those items, and they are sometimes even more willing to pay more because they are desperate. But don't take this wrong, because I don't tell you to be greedy. I hate greedy people. So what I mean is that not even standing in trade world, you can help people and earn some pocket money. Be nice, be friendly, don't ask them rip their ass off. I don't usually tell a price, I ask them offer, because I think it's more fair. Because there is people that are poor, they are new people, they can't afford much. So I think it's fair that I help them, and this is why I'm willing to sell items sometimes even cheaper than they are, because I just want to help someone. And I know that there is always some other people that is willing to pay more, so it will later cover up my earlier loss. So it doesn't matter really. Just be nice and help and have those items. You can actually make a someone's day by being friendly and helping. And I think it gives me more than some coins. I like to help people because it makes RuneScape more enjoyable. But anyway, if I mention you some items that you might want to stack to get money, those are holy symbols. They are often graded for 5k, 10k. Silver bars, 1 to 2k. A rupee amulet, they are often asked to buy 10k. Even bread, they are easy to make or thief, and people might buy them for 1k. Molten glass, as well as blanks, unfired bowls, they are often bought like 5 to 10k. Other than those, beads, rough gold, bronze fire, steel nails, game necklace, jewel rings, gold bars. There is a lot of items. Just learn to read that chat and you will notice those items that are easy to sell. So next time when you are in a bank and you are stealing, and if you are not running after experience like Eresuomi, look at that chat and you will notice those same items are asked over and over again. You can take advantage of that and you can get some candy money out of them. So try it. You will surprise.